Hey everyone, Zane here and welcome to Mr. Armageddon Builds. Today we're going to have some fun with my most recent project, a classic potato cannon. Also known as a Tatter Tosser or a Spud Launcher, I have two variants of cannons that we're going to showcase today. First up, we have what I'm calling my advanced potato cannon. And then we have one that's more of a classic design I'm calling my basic cannon. We're going to go through the design and operation of each cannon, talk about propellants, demo the firing process, and see what kind of distance we can get from each one. Then we'll see what each of these does against various targets. Let's get to it. Here we have a good look at our advanced potato cannon. What qualifies this as an advanced cannon is that it has a few features that you won't find on a normal spud gun. First off, we have a propane injection system utilizing a standard Burns-O-Matic 14-ounce propane cylinder. Propane is metered with a pressure regulator and an inline ball valve to ensure we get just the right amount in the firing chamber for our fuel air mixture and to give us the perfect shot every time. We also have some electronics built in that allow us to properly mix the propane with the air in the chamber before firing, using this control box here, connected to an 80mm fan that's inside the chamber. After firing, we can open this ball valve and use the fan again to expel the spent propellant, quickly getting us ready for the next firing sequence. I designed and 3D printed a pistol grip to house the electronic barbecue igniter, which is connected to our firing chamber spark gap. We have an interchangeable barrel using these irrigation cam locks. This disconnect system lets us quickly change out our barrels to different sizes, allowing us to launch things like golf balls, marbles, soda cans, and even entire rolls of toilet paper. When firing standard potatoes, most spud guns are muzzle loaders, meaning you shove the projectile from the end of the barrel down to the base of the firing chamber using a ramrod or a broomstick. Our advanced cannon uses these cam locks, allowing us to load from the rear of the barrel, making it a breech loader, which is much easier and faster to load compared to a muzzle loader. Another upgrade comes in this adjustable riser I designed and 3D printed, allowing us to support the weight of these longer barrels so we don't get any bending in the barrel while firing. Last up on the feature list, the chamber itself and part of our barrel are made of a transparent acrylic, allowing us to see the beauty of combustion up close. One more thing that I guess helps this qualify as an advanced spud gun is that it is made up of a lot of components. According to my list, we are currently sitting at around 45 individual parts to build this cannon. Speaking of the parts list, I have actually made a course available online that walks through the entire build process in detail for each of the cannons featured in this video, including a parts list with purchase links, chamber and barrel ratio calculators, and a few other goodies that can help anyone build one of these awesome devices, regardless of your skill level. If you would like more information on the course, hit up the link in the video description. Obviously, hairspray has been the legacy propellant of choice for most potato cannons. I was using that back when I was in middle school making these things. But although it's very effective and it works, it gets really gunked up and nasty inside the chambers and can make it hard to take things apart and unscrew your end caps. So we're going to try out some different propellants and see if anything fires a lot cleaner, maybe more power, and heck, even smells better. So let's go ahead and run through these and see how they do. Now the first segment of this video is simply we're going to test the flammability directly out of the bottle. So it doesn't really relate exactly how it's going to perform in the chamber, but we'll see how big the flame gets and how it reacts. So let's get started. This one's my favorite. One more starting fluid. All right, so to test out, before actually firing, we have this setup here in this gun vise. I just have a tennis ball plugged in the end. It's not tight. It's gonna just pop out, but it's just to keep the propellant from just leaking out the front when I do this.
So it's just gonna sit in there, it'll pop out once these fire off. But mainly, again, this is just to see how it reacts in the chamber. We saw the flame test, now we'll see how the chamber does. And then once we figure out which ones work best just as is, we'll actually attach the barrel and fire some potatoes off. So let's get to it. All right, next up, the hairspray that has alcohol. This one's probably gonna do better. This is like Aquanet, so. Okay. All right, moving on to the carb cleaner. Brake cleaner. Let's not have a flame going inside. All right, so brake cleaner ignites, but not, it's a slower ignition, not a lot of pressure behind it, so I'm thinking that's probably a no. All right, starter fluid. That was pretty good. All right. Isopropylene, 91% alcohol. Two sprays. Okay, two sprays.
Well, we just reconfirmed that cheap alcohol-based hairspray works really well. Again, you want to go cheap because the cheaper the hairspray, the more alcohol it has as a percentage. The downside to hairspray is, of course, the stickiness and the gunk you get in the chamber. Carb cleaner worked pretty well. Starting fluid, two squirts, works really well. And then two squirts of alcohol worked great as well. Plus, it's going to be very clean and it'll evaporate away after you shoot it. So for the basic cannons, those are the propellants that I would mess around with and see which provides the best distance. Now, speaking of distance, let's go ahead and move on to the firing of these cannons.
Mosquito.
And
here we have the basic cannon. This is more of your standard classic potato cannon, utilizing a rear opening to put in your propellant. It also utilizes, just like the advanced cannon, an electronic barbecue igniter to ignite the propellant side. Now this one does use the same cam system, so I can easily change out barrel sizes or break it down for storage. This one does not allow for breech loading from the back. This one uses your standard ramrod method where you're gonna put the potato in the front, shove it down, and then fire it off. But a lot simpler in design, still works great. So let's go ahead and fire these two up and see what they can do.
All right, so now we're gonna go ahead and show the firing sequence and do some distance tests with these cannons. But I wanted to show this picture right here of the two cannons side by side just to give you some perspective as to how big they are and, you know, kind of how they look side by side. So these are the cannons. Let's start firing.
All right, so we're gonna go through the basic firing sequence for the advanced cannon. So what we have is, first off, we have our propane injection system. And so we're gonna let some propane into this chamber here. We have two valves to allow this to happen, and then it'll pass through into the chamber. So first off, I'm gonna let the propane inside. I'm gonna see how it's pressurized. And then basically, once I see my meter here, I let in around 10 PSI is what I've been doing to get a good shot with this thing so far. So we're gonna play with that and see what we get. But once it's in there, you make sure, before you put it inside the chamber, you make sure that this valve is shut, open, shut, and push the little button right here. If I can show you guys this. We're gonna push this button right here to activate the fan, mix up the mixture inside, and then we can pop one off. So let's go ahead and do that here. So first step, I'm gonna take off the barrel and pop the potato in the back. So here we have, I took the barrel off the cam locks there. And so what I've done is I've sharpened down the edge of this barrel, so it's called a muzzle knife, basically. And so what this does is when you pop the potato down, you smack it, and it shaves the potato and gets a nice, good seal in that barrel. So we're gonna go ahead and do that, and make sure you have a potato that's wide enough to get shaved off and have that nice seal. So that looks pretty good. Okay. So pop the cans forward. Pop it in. Snap these two back. Now it's locked in. So now we're gonna go ahead and inject the propane in the system. So with this propane tank installed, I'm gonna go ahead and shut both my valves. Make sure that this again is shut as well. And now we're gonna let in some propane. I'm gonna turn on my meter.
Hold on, going back 20 seconds.
Okay, heard that go in there. And then I'm gonna go pop some in there. And then do the same thing here. And again, you're not letting in a lot. It does not need a lot. It's very minimal. I'm actually gonna like quarter turn it off. Okay. And then we're gonna fire. So let's see what it does. Hey girls, watch out.
Yes.
Whew.
That's some good distance.
So let's readjust the camera, do it again, see what kind of distance we could get. But before I shoot the second shot, open this valve up. We're gonna hit the fan button. That little actuator light goes on, and you guys probably can't see it. No, you can't see it. But there's a fan in there that's taking all the propellant and just getting any exhaust out of this chamber. So now we're ready for shot number two.
All right, so now let's take a look at some of the distance we got with this advanced cannon. I went ahead and did three shots, and I had my kids run out to the potato landing zone and used my laser rangefinder to tag the distance of these three shots. So let's take a look at what we got. Our first shot here, although respectable for a potato cannon, was the least distance-wise of the three shots I did, coming in at 649 feet. Shot number two was a little bit better, coming in at 679 feet. The final of my three shots was the best, coming in at 702 feet. So that's pretty decent. I've had better distances using pneumatic potato cannons, but for a combustion cannon, 700 feet is pretty dang good. So definitely pleased with that result. So with that other way, with the advanced cannon, let's go ahead and take a look at our basic cannon, fired off, and then the highlight of this video, blowing up some produce. So let's get to firing off the basic cannon.
All right, so basic cannon operation, pretty simple, straightforward. We're leaving the cam lock engaged. That's just to break it down for storage or change out the barrel size. So we're gonna do a nice, make sure again, that your muzzle knife is smaller than the potato itself. So I'll show you there that. And then good smack down. Okay, and then this one's again, your standard kind of muzzle loader. Okay, so I'm just gonna leverage a mop handle. And if I measure that down, I basically want it to go to the very bottom of the barrel, so we will do that now. And when you do that, make sure the end cap is off your barrel, because otherwise you'll create a lot of pressure and it's harder to get it down. Now, you can see inside there the two bolts that connect. And when I hit the button here, there's a spark that fires. But we're gonna use for this one, we have a propane test. We show all kinds of cool different things. We are just gonna use standard hairspray in this guy. I like to do a 1001, 1002 count. Pretty decent. So one thing that's sometimes helpful, I have this little this pipe wrench. A lot of times, because the pressure that gets built up because it's in the chamber, it can be hard to get the end cap off. So a pipe wrench can really help crank that end cap and get it off. So we're gonna just take it off. You can see this got some exhaust. We're gonna get out. All right, and we're gonna do it again. Oblong potato. Now let's go ahead and shoot some stuff. Well, there you go. I had a lot of fun making these, but I'm already thinking about ways to make both of these cannons even better. So maybe I'll do a Mark II sometime in the future. This is one of the many projects I've been working on lately. And as I mentioned earlier, if you would like to build one of these cannons, I provide a link in the video description for a free ebook and an affordable course that I put together that shows the entire build process in detail, digital plans, and purchase links for everything needed. So be sure to check that out. Let me know what you think of this project, or if you've done anything like this, hit me up in the comments. I hope this video earned your subscription or even a like. I have a lot of cool projects coming up, so stay tuned for more. I'm Zane, this is Mr. Armageddon Builds, and thanks for stopping by.